Don't ever let somebody tell you you can't do something. You got a dream, you got to protect it. People can't do something themselves. They want to tell you you can't do it. Go get it. Period.
Can you imagine what would happen if we could have any dream?
You tell me why you're not going.
Because why? I've been to a million auditions, and the same thing happens every time, where I get interrupted because someone wants to get a sandwich, or I'm crying and they start laughing, or there's people sitting in the waiting room and they're like me but prettier and better at the, because maybe I'm not good enough.
Yes, you are.
No, maybe I'm not.
Yes, you are.
Maybe I'm not. Maybe I'm one of those people that has always wanted to do it, but it's like a pipe dream. You said it. You change your dreams and then you grow up. Maybe I'm one of those people. And it's been 6 years and I don't want to do it anymore.
Why don't you want to do it anymore?
Because they think it hurts a little bit too much.
All right, hey, what's up, guys? So I'm currently in one of my favorite places in Los Angeles. I'm at Griffith Park. I always come here just to relax and have serenity and have peace and to hike and just to have recollection on all the amazing things that have happened in my life. And today is no different. I am finally proud to say that I've been signed to a major talent agency. And I'm not gonna cry this video, at least I'm gonna try not to, because I know in every video where I talk about my dreams, I do, but I've been waiting for this day for almost 24 years. You know, you guys have seen my journey on this channel of finding an agent. I went to my first acting agency last winter in December of 2017, and they told me that I wasn't ready yet. And then I went again last summer, and they told me once again that I wasn't ready yet, and I was auditioning and I was going through the steps of getting an agent and of finding one, and it's one of the top 10 agencies in LA, and I'm so super duper proud of this moment. Like, I've just been like working out, and like I literally ran here in my pajamas, guys, just to like run it all off, because like I just can't believe my life. And I've waited like my entire life for moments like these. I'm sorry, guys. Oh my God. I said I wasn't gonna cry. Okay, so I just wanna backtrack a little bit and give you guys a little bit of my acting story. So I lived in Cincinnati, Ohio, where there wasn't a lot of people. You know, I didn't know somebody who knew somebody who knew somebody who knew somebody who was in the entertainment industry or acting. So I never thought that it was a possibility for me. And I will never forget every single summer and year, like clockwork, my Aunt Jackie would always bring home a VHS of a Leonardo DiCaprio movie, starting with Basketball Diaries and Titanic and Romeo and Juliet. And speaking of Titanic, I will never forget seeing that film for the first time when I was 4 years old. And I realized that that's what I wanted to do for the rest of my life, that I wanted to be an actor. When Leonardo screamed out, "I'm the king of the world," I said, that's what I wanna do. That's what I wanna be. I don't know what that is. I don't know if that's being a lawyer or accountant. I don't know if that's being on a cruise ship. I have no idea, but I just wanted to do whatever he was doing. And I've worked my butt off to get to this point, and now I'm here. I started acting, at least pursuing acting professionally, when I was about 10 years old. I auditioned for Barney in 2001 or 2002 in all the PBS kid shows. Nothing was really successful. A movie called Seabiscuit was shooting in town. That's on my resume. But I just really wasn't successful when I was 10. So I decided to go back at it again when I was 17. And I had the conversation with myself that I think that every actor at least should have with themselves, which is this something that I want to do for the rest of my life? Is this something that I'm gonna pursue, that I'm not gonna give up on, that I'm not gonna look back on? My first ever real big audition, at least two, was for Teen Beach Movie on Disney Channel, and then The Get Down. And I will never forget, I think The Get Down was around the same time, maybe it was after, but I will never forget, I got a call back for that. And it was one of my first auditions. I didn't eventually make it onto the show, but I continued going, and I continued auditioning for stuff while I was in college, and balancing schoolwork, but then submitting self-tapes, and emailing casting directors. And I remember one summer, I emailed over like 600 casting directors asking to be a part of their films and of their television shows, and four responded and they allowed me to audition. And sometimes that's what you gotta do to pursue your dream. And I will never forget, one casting director wrote me back and said, "Tywan, do you have an agent?" And I said, "Well, no, I don't have an agent." And they were like, "Well, you need an agent to get started." I emailed Ka, because everybody's talking about Ka, CAA. So I learned the hard way after emailing those top four agencies for about 3 years. And then after a while, I started submitting myself on my own projects on websites like Actors Access, Cast It Talent, Backstage. I booked my first television role, which was on a television show called Fatal Attraction. It was an investigation discovery type of show. And then I eventually booked Law & Order 2 months later. They were looking for any gender, any ethnicity, and they chose a kid from Cincinnati, Ohio to do the role. And I wasn't even living in New York at the time. I had to fly back and forth, but I'll include all those Law & Order vlogs down below. So after I did that, I felt much more confident to start emailing more boutique agencies and smaller agencies. And I started doing that, and I was meeting with them, and it just wasn't a fit. You know, they saw me in reenactment shows or to play the thug role, and I did not. I wanted to be on shows like Riverdale and Pretty Little Liars Perfectionist, this upcoming HBO show called Euphoria, and things like that. You know, they didn't see me in those things, so I had to unfortunately turn them down just because we didn't see eye to eye. You know, it's kind of like dating for the first time. You know, we didn't see eye to eye on something, so you move on. And then I reached out to another agent. The woman who discovered Zac Efron and Leonardo DiCaprio, at least she was one half of the duo that did, I found out who her agent partner was, because everybody knows that you have an agent and a manager. I reached out to her, and she said, yeah, great, let's meet in a month. She asked me to reschedule. I did. We rescheduled. I was emailed once again the night before the meeting, and it was canceled. And I was devastated. I didn't think that I was ever gonna pursue acting again, because I thought this was my moment. I felt like that this was it, you know, that there was no more going after my dream. I'm from Ohio as it is, like this isn't gonna happen. This wasn't meant for me, I should just give up. But after about 20 minutes and a nice little nap that morning, I got back up and I emailed the other half of the duo that discovered Leonardo DiCaprio. And he submitted my profile to everybody in his agency, and I was called in for a meeting with my current agent, and he signed me, and he told me that in 2 days he would give me the final verdict. And this is 2 days later, and I'm proud to say that I'm officially signed with a major talent agency. And it hasn't been without tough times, without moments of doubt, without feeling like this was never gonna happen for me. And don't get me wrong, I don't think that I'm going to be a major movie star tomorrow. I know it's going to take time. I know that, you know, I'll probably go in an audition a week, or maybe an audition every 2 weeks. Auditions are few and far between. But this video is all about achieving a dream and achieving a goal and never giving up on it and making sure that you just keep on going after whatever you dream. And I know I have a lot of subscribers on this channel now. You know, a lot of you guys don't necessarily want to be actors, but even if you want to be a chef or an accountant or whatever you want to be, just never give up on your dream, because it will happen. And I'm testament. And I've done so many things in my life that I thought were impossible, like becoming my commencement speaker at graduation in my college, or even doing Shark Tank, or even getting into my college, which was far from Ohio. And I'm just so proud. You know, I don't usually like talking like this because I don't want to be braggadocious, but I think it's so important to tell people your dream and to show people that it can happen if you never give up on yourself. Cried enough this week. I already cried this morning. I like called my mom. I was like, Mom, it happened. It happened. I'm so excited. But if you have a dream, I hope that you never ever give up on it. I hope that you keep on going after any and everything that you want from this lifetime, because it can happen, and I'm testament. You know, this journey has taken, you know, I don't know, 17 years almost, you know, from the time I started auditioning professionally, and 21 from the time that I decided that I wanted to be an actor, you know, and it hasn't been easy. And yes, I did all the things that people in Ohio do, which is, you know, go to the mall and go to the middle desk and say, I want to be an actor. And they're like, well, give us $3,000. And like, you know, you think that that's the way to go. But to finally have a legitimate acting agency with the guy who discovered Leonardo DiCaprio, like, I hope I'm not giving anything like too personal away, but this is such a full circle moment for me. I can't believe the wonderful things that God has offered me in this lifetime, and I thank him every single day for all the beautiful and wonderful things. And I'm really excited for this next chapter, and I'm excited to see what's gonna happen. So yeah, it's gonna be good. I have like a little peanut gallery up here, guys. You can't see. I gotta pack. I'm moving to LA on Monday. and I'm gonna start auditioning for things. And if I'm a movie star tomorrow, or if I'm a movie star in a couple of months, or if I'm a movie star in a year, I thank you guys so much for always supporting my acting journey. It's moments like these and the times when you guys leave comments down below that really make me never wanna give up and make me wanna keep on going after my dreams. And I said that I wasn't gonna cry, but I've just worked so hard for this. All right, guys, I'm gonna finish my hike. Peace out. I'm moving to LA on Monday. Bye, guys.